main finding of the State of the World Youth Report is that education is a key driver in leveling opportunity inequalities. That is, when you have a society with inequality as the starting point, then it'd be very difficult actually to have outcomes that benefits everyone. So education, as a matter of fact, especially among females, is a key driver to promote equality, at least to provide opportunities so that they can have a better outcome in life. This is one of the key findings that we have. Having said that, education per se is not the only component that's important. It's necessary, but not a sufficient factor. What are the other factors? For example, you need to have education that is commensurate with the labor market demand. Because having gotten literacy education itself does not guarantee a job, but it gives you a better standing, better starting point than if you haven't had an education. What do the decision makers think are not always what the young people want? There needs to be, the young people's voices need to be heard. That is where UN Habitat comes into picture. We are trying to provide a second and third level opportunities for these young people in a way who have dropped out of schools, who haven't been able to get on to the mainstream of education or employment, able to see how through Habitat's work we can engage young people and to see what the needs are. The key to youth development is youth-led initiative, an initiative that takes in consideration young people's own creativity, engages other generations. That's, I think, Habitat support.
Urbanization is an extremely important phenomenon, particularly in the 21st century. We all know that half of humanity now live in the cities, and there are consequences for the physical environment, for the natural environment, and for the way people live, for the way countries and cities grow and generate wealth. This is the focus of this report. We know that when urbanization occurs in a chaotic manner, it leads to formation of slums. This has been a subject matter for UN Habitat for a very long time. This year, we are trying to focus on the human dimension of urbanization. This report speaks to bridging the urban divide, because we know that the cities are not inclusive. We have divided the report, the themes of this report, into four critical dimensions: economic, social, political, and cultural dimensions of cities. And we find that the drivers of inclusion reside in the way human beings have evolved over time, the kinds of skills, the kinds of education, the kinds of background from which they come from. And therefore, this report focuses almost very narrowly in all its message, in all the chapters, on how cities become exclusive to some, how inequality comes about, and therefore how unequal cities develop in time. So this is the key message of this report. So in short, what we want to ensure is that we are sounding the alarm, as it were. We are giving out information, as it were, and showing the consequences of inaction. Because one of the biggest problems, of developing nations sometimes is inaction. Inaction that are due to lack of resources. Sometimes we don't look forward enough. We need to begin to look to 10 years down the road, 20 years down the road. So this report is targeted at all these people, and of course also the multilateral agencies, the donor community, to help the poorest of the poor countries, and also other partners of the UN who might also be doing similar work. so that we can all work together to send this message to the whole world.
The main findings of the report is that if we level the playing field, then everybody has a chance in life. Because then you give all the young people a foundation on which basis they can be able to have a future. Because if you give an example of a young person who is coming from a slum area and a young person who is coming from a well-to-do area, if they don't have the same access to education, obviously their outcomes will be different. So our argument is that why don't we give all of them a chance, which means a level playing field up to a certain level. And this is in terms of education. Let me give you an example. You can give them from primary A up to all levels. And then what happens after that, it is up to them. But at least you know that they had a chance and they had a level playing field. They had the same access to education. Our hope is that the recommendations will be able to get to the governments, particularly local governments. And also, we are trying to get the youth to be able to speak to their governments through this report. By giving the youth perspective, we are reporting what the young people are saying and what they want their governments to be able to implement in national policies, both at national level and local level. And also, we feel that if we are talking about inclusive governance and young people are one of the major components of our populations, their voices should be heard. So we believe that they can be heard through this report.